Yeah, students, are you able to see the PPT?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, in last lecture, we discussed about the generalized equation of H parameter, right? So in total there are four H parameters. H11, H12, H21, H22. H11 is referred as HI, right? So here you can say H11. This is referred as HI and it is input impedance, right? And unit is in ohm. Then H12 is the reverse voltage gain V1 by V2, right? And it is referred by HR, reverse, and it has no unit. Then H21 is I2 by I1. So this is forward current gain and referred by HF. It has no unit. Then H22. It is I2 by V2, right? So it is output admittance and referred as HO. And its unit is mu ohm inverse or Siemens, right? So here you can find the four parameters. They are having mixed type of unit because HI has ohm unit, HO has no unit, HR has no unit, HF has no unit, and HO has unit of admittance. So since the units are mixed, that's why it is called as hybrid, right? Hybrid means mix. So due to this reason, it is called as hybrid parameter, right? So why it is called as hybrid parameter? Because the parameters have mixed units, right? Okay. So these are the generalized equations here. V1 is equal to HI1 plus HR V2, and I2 is equal to HF I1 plus HO V2. Now from these equations, equation number 3 and equation number 4, we can draw the generalized electrical model of the transistor. Okay, so here now generalized model of transistor. Okay, so for this generalized model, we will use equation number 3 and equation number 4. Okay, so first I will write the equation number 3 again there. V1 is equal to HII1 plus HRV2. So this is our equation number 3rd. Now from this equation, now see, suppose this is our two port network. Here, this is our two port network having two terminals this side. So here we have the voltage marked as V1 and current which is marked as I1, and here we have two other terminals where the voltage is marked as V2 and current is marked as I2, right? So now we have to draw the generalized model of this box, which is your two port network. So here, this side. These two terminals is marked as 1, 1 dash, right? This terminal 1, 1 dash. Here it is 2, 2 dash. At 1 and 1 dash we have a voltage V1. Now you come to this first term of this equation. V1 is equal to H1 I1, right? So see, this left side, it is voltage of this equation number 3, left side. This is voltage. And in right side, we have two terms. We have two terms, term number 1 and term number 2. Right? So we know that if suppose we are having some this type, 13 meter is equal to term 1. And there is some term 2. If we are having left side this 30 meter, then in the right side term 1, its unit will also be in meter, right? Its unit will also be in how you measure the distance in that meter. And term 2 will also be meter, because we can add term 1 and term 2, which will be in the unit of distance, right? So this also meter. Then only we can equate this with this 30 meter, right? So same way here in equation number 3, In equation number 3, since in the left hand side we have the voltage, so in the right hand side term 1 and term 2, they should also be in voltage, right? They should also be in voltage. Now you see the term 1. Term 1 we are having H1 or HI into I1. So here what we are doing, we are multiplying the current. We are multiplying the current with some term HI so that we can get a voltage. Right? We can get a voltage. So now the question is, what should be HI? What should be HI? So that if we multiply that with the current, then it will give us voltage.
H11.
No, that H11, that is correct. HI, you can write HI. Or you can write H11. It does not matter. It does not matter at H1, right? But the question is, what you multiply with the current? Here you have the current I1, right? What you multiply with the current so that you can get a unit of voltage? Yes. Who can respond this? What you multiply with the current so that you can get the voltage?
Impedance.
Impedance, right. So if HI is resistance, right? If HI is resistance, then if you multiply this resistance with the current, what you get?
Voltage.
We get voltage, right? We get voltage. So same thing is there in the term 1. I1 is there, right? With that you are multiplying HI. This means HI is I1 is I, current. Then HI will be resistance. Right or wrong? So here you see, In this terminal, here you can see in two port network diagram, there is a current I1, right? There is a current I1. So with this current, if I connect here one resistance, this, right? And the value of this resistance is HI. Okay? So you will get a voltage across HI. You will get that. So HI, already we discussed here, you see here HI. What is HI? HI is H11, that is correct, H11. Its unit is ohm. From here also you can understand this. Its unit is ohm. This means HI is resistance, right? So HI is resistance. So here we have connected one resistance. And what is its value? HI is its value, right? Now you see the second term. Second term is HR into V2, right? Second term is HR into V2. Okay, here I write HR into V2. What unit we expect here? Because you see term 2, you are adding with term 1, right? And both of these addition will give you V1. That is a voltage. So here term 1 and term 2 both should be voltages. In term 1, we already calculated HI is a resistance, so it will give the voltage across this resistance. So term one is voltage. Now what about term two? HR into V2 should give you voltage, right? So what is HR? Something you are, HR is something which is, which you are multiplying with V2 voltage, and it is giving you same unit voltage. So what will be HR?
Voltage gain.
So this is V2. This means it is some constant value, right or wrong, constant or some value, some numerical value. It will be some numerical value. It can be 20 or it can be 30 or it can be any value without unit, right? It can be a value without unit. So here now this term, second term, you can represent here this is plus, this is minus, and this is your HRV2, right? This is HRV2. So here this HRV2 is dependent voltage source. It is dependent voltage source. Right, so it is dependent voltage source depends on
V2.
Yes, depends on V2, right? So, right. So now you see, if you apply Kirchhoff's voltage law in this loop, you apply KVL, right? We are moving in anti-clockwise direction. So what expression you will get? So here you see, this is V1, and across this resistor you are getting a voltage drop, that is your HI1, and voltage will be like terminal will be the sign of is plus here and minus here, right? So if you are moving in anti-clockwise direction, then you will get here V1 minus HI1. Then you move through this HRV2 voltage, this dependent voltage source. So again, plus to minus you are moving. You are moving in this way, plus to minus. So it will give you minus HR V2, right? So if you, and this is equal to zero, right? So these two minus terms, if you bring towards the right side of this equality symbol, then you will get equation number Okay, so in this way we have modeled this equation number 3 in this way. This is the electrical model of equation number 3. Now we will write the equation number 4 and model that. So what is our equation number 4? This is I2 is equal to HF. Yes, tell me, HF.
HF
I1 plus
H0 V2.
Right. This is our equation number 4. So now this equation we have to convert it in electrical model. Right. So now here you see on the left hand side it is I2. Right. So this is the current. So in the right hand side you have two terms, term number 1 and term number 2. These two terms are there. Okay, so I will draw terminal 2 and terminal 2 dash plus minus. Here we have a voltage V2 and here we have current I2, right? So now if you see some this type of equation, you see some this type of equation, from here some current is flowing, let us assume it is I2. Okay, and I am writing this equation. So now this I2 at this junction, if you apply Kirchhoff's current law, then this I2 will be divided in two parts. Right, suppose here we are having Ix, right? So here will be Iy, right? So I2 current which is coming here, it at the junction, it will be divided in two parts. One is Ix and another is Iy. So in terms of equation, if you want to write, then how you will write? I2 is equal to Ix plus Iy. In this way you can write, right? Now you see your equation number 3. How you have written equation number 3? I3 is equal to HF I1, right, plus HO V2. So this means this term and this term, these two terms are also the currents, right? It will also be current. So same type of this type of circuitry you will find, right? Because HF I1, Now here you just see HF. What will be HF? Means here you are multiplying HF with the current I1, right? With the current I1, and you are expected to get a current only, right? Because here left hand side it is I3, so I3 means then right hand side the terms, these terms you are having, these are the current terms, right? So HF will be a constant number, right? So this HF, it will be a constant. A constant means it will be a numerical value. It will be a numerical value. Unitless, it will be a unitless value, because it may be 20 or it may be 30, like this. Because if you multiply that with the I1, then you will get a unit of current only. That is ampere unit you will get, right? So HF is a numerical value. So what is HF? We have already seen here. HF, this HF, you see, it is a non-unit value. It is the current gain, forward current gain, it non-unit value. So this HF is a non-unit value. So here what we can do, here I can connect one dependent current source and its value will be HF I1. Can we draw this? Right. Now you come to the second term, this H naught V2, right? So now you just see in V2 means voltage, what you are multiplying. You are multiplying H naught. So if you multiply H naught with V2, and what unit you are expecting, what unit we will have?
MOS.
No, you don't think about that way, in that way. From this equation we have written, I3 is equal to, we are adding two terms. Now one of the term is H0V2, right? One of the term is H0V2. So what unit you will get? So that I3 is the unit of the current, right? I3 is the current. So if you multiply something with V2, so you are expecting a unit of current, right? You are expecting a unit of current. So what you can do? So what should be H0 now? From this explanation, now you can understand this H0 will be admittance.
Admittance.
Right? Because you see, I is equal to V/R. I is equal to V/R. Right? So, or you can write in this way, 1/R multiplied by V, correct? I is equal to 1/R multiplied by V. Here you are having V, this. So this H naught, what is this? H naught is 1/R, right? It is 1/R, and this is your admittance. This is your admittance, right? Okay, you tell me one thing. If I say you draw the resistance symbol, then how you will draw? Resistance symbol will be this. if I say you draw the symbol of admittance, then how you will draw? What is the symbol of admittance? Yeah, anyone having any idea? What is the symbol of admittance? Its unit is okay, different. But what is the symbol?
Mo, sir. Mo.
Mo is the unit, right? Suppose right. this resistance is 10 ohm, right? This resistance is 10, unit is ohm, okay?
Resistance symbol only.
Yes. Who is this girl? What is your name?
Harisha.
Okay, Harisha. That is yes, correct. Sir. You see, this resistance, suppose its value is 10 ohm. Okay? And I ask, what is the admittance of R? What is the admittance of R? Then, what you will write?
0.1.
It is 0.1. And unit is?
Mo.
Mo, sir.
Okay. MHO. So 10 ohm is equal to 0.1 mo. It is correct?
Yes, sir.
Is it correct? And suppose if in this symbol, if you write 10 ohm, you can write 10 ohm also, or you can write 0.1 MHO, this also you can write, right? Both are same. Only thing is, you are representing the resistance in different unit. That's all, right? So this the meaning is, the admittance and resistance both are represented by different units, but their symbol is same. But their symbol is same, right? So now this resistance is 10 ohm and this admittance is 0.1 mu. Now you see this equation here, the H naught B2. So if you multiply V2 with 1 by R, you will get the current, right? You will get the current. And what is 1 by R? How you will represent 1 by R as a symbol? You represent it by this resistance only. So now you see this part here, this resistance, right? You see this resistance here. We have at the terminal, we have the voltage V2. Okay. From this, now in this arm where we have connected the resistance, this IX, what is this IX? This IX is H naught V2. It is correct or not? You just see.
Yes, sir.
It is H naught V2 because you see this equation. I3 is equal to HFI1. HFI1 is this part. This is HFI1. And this second arm, that is H naught V2, right? V2 is the voltage at the terminal. So this current, H naught V2, is one current. So this resistance which you are representing here, this is your H naught. This is your H naught. And you are multiplying this with the V2, then you are getting a current in this arm, right? So this equation 3 you can represent in this way. Now we come to this side here. Now see this terminal 2 and 2 dash. Voltage across this terminal is V2 and I2 current is flowing. So here we will connect one resistance, right? And see in the left side here, one resistance is there. And how, what is the value of this resistance? HI. And this is the resistance. HI is the resistance. And here you have this resistance which is H naught, right? But this is an impedance, right? Because you draw the symbol of resistance, but you can write its value in terms of resistance, or you can write its value in terms of impedance. Okay. So here you will find the current flowing in this arm. And what is this current? This current is H naught V2. Right? This current is H naught V2. Now there is another arm. In this arm you will find another current is flowing like this. This is another current. This way. And this current you represent it by HF I1. So here this HF I1 is dependent current source. Dependent current source. Depends on, depends on I1, right? Depends on I1. Now you just see in this, so here this left, this right side electrical model is for equation number 4 and left side is for equation number 3. Now you just see one thing. HRV2, this is a dependent voltage source. It depends, its value depends upon V2, right? And V2 is the voltage at the terminal 2, this side. And HFI1, this is a dependent current source. Its value depends on I1. I1 is the current in this side, correct? So this means both of these models are physically joined together. So you join this model like this. Okay? Because voltage source in left side, dependent voltage source of left side, HRV2, depends upon voltage V2. V2 is at the terminal voltage 2 and 2 dash. And dependent current source HFI1 depends on the current I1, which is in the terminal 1 and 1 dash. So they are electrically joined together. So this is the model, right? This is a transistor model, right? So in this two port network, this box is represented by this circuitry, right? It is represented by this circuitry. Okay. Any question? Any doubt?